Hey there, Phono friends. Another exciting edition of As the Record Turns, and revisiting a post from about a month ago where I made these outer shells for the number four reproducer, which always tend to fail. And just for kicks, I made some out of a very lightweight resin and was interested in seeing with the lighter weight sound box, how would the sound quality sound? Initially, the first one that I made, there were some problems with air leaks, but after giving it another couple weeks to cure and some heat treatment, also the back flange needed a little silicone. So with that all done, I wanted to show you a little more information, and then we're going to give it a quick sound test. Here's the original pop metal one, which weighs in at about 53 grams. Here is a copy that comes in at 13 grams. And now if we do a little comparison, here's a fully assembled, complete with needle, ready to go, all brass, number two. I only noticed that it has one of my nice little silicone gaskets in it, a nice accurate one piece. This comes in just shy of 150 grams, assembled and ready to go. And if we compare that to the number four with the lightweight outer half, not quite half the weight, but wow, look at that. That is significantly lighter. The big question is, what's the difference in sound quality? So stay tuned, and I'm going to move over to the Victrola and we'll have a listen. Okay, here we go. As a test, we have Sugarfoot Stomp by some guy named Fletcher Henderson. You may have heard of him. I heard he was popular. And we've got the number two ready to go. Try to get the vocal.
I'll play that thing.
Okay, same disc, same style needle, still a fresh one, and we've got the lightweight number four, and I'm going to try to play it back at the same spot. One of the best things about our hobby is that we get to enjoy all kinds of wonderful music that are not only made from natural materials, but they're also powered purely by muscle Everything's hand crank. Materials such as steel and brass and clay and latex, tree rubber. These are all things that we just take for granted as part of the hobby. And they're all wonderful materials, and it was absolutely fantastic the level of sophistication that people were able to achieve with them in regards to the reproduction of sound well over a century ago. And I'm all for both preserving it and continuing that research. However, we do now have some new materials at our disposal, and I hope that the following couple minutes showed that some materials such as polyurethane can reproduce reproducer parts that are much lighter in weight, giving comparable performance and presumably being lighter in weight, that they would also put less stress on the record, reducing wear and giving us many more plays out of them. So going forward, I hope that more of you will experiment with these readily available and inexpensive materials, materials that we can work with at home at minimal cost and really produce some really amazing results. And if anybody wants to get involved in such, I certainly hope that you'll reach out to me and ask questions, and I'm happy to help. Thank you for watching.